Welcome back. This is Greybeard. And I think in this episode, I'm not going to tackle any large projects like I had been in the last few episodes, but I'm just going to kind of chill a bit and do some smaller things around the base. I've got a couple small things going. I'll walk you through some of them. You'll see. I'll show you a few things here and there. First thing I want to do is make a little simple. I hope it's simple. I hope it will fit here. Scoot farm. I'll go make some more. I should dig out some more. Okay, more supplies. Okay, we have 25 hoppers down there that are under 25 rails that are under 25 hopper minecarts that will soon be under 25 sandblocks. And on top of these sandblocks, we will have some turtle eggs. I'll have some glass here to keep the turtles in so they don't go wandering. Maybe a block here so I can get in, or I can just get in this way. Let me go fetch. I'll go fetch some turtle eggs. Okay, there's 5 eggs there. There'll soon be 5 baby turtles. And then 5 adult turtles. And then I'll have 5 scoots in here. And we'll see how that goes. Simple enough. Another thing I do every now and then, I have a new tree farm. It's not a very interesting one. It's just a bunch of trees. Next year, it's just a 5x5 grid of saplings. Well, so that's another thing I do every now and then. Just chop down trees. Trees and saplings and sticks and apples and such in my storage. I've got a nice collection of oak. Getting good. There's another thing I'm going to work on. I've got it marked out 5 wide. Oh, I've got to actually, I can do this here. That should be good. And one there, Yeah, I think I might have to do one on the ceiling. Okay, here's an approximation for what it's worth. This is for fuel, which I don't have, but I'll put some of these in here. But... Oh, alright, and this is for things to burn. And this is stuff that gets burnt. Yes, you guessed it. This is a smelter I'm going to build. I'm not going to bore you with it, really. Come on. It's going to be done off camera. And this may not be the final place where these go, but this is where I'll start for now. I can move around. It's going to take a lot more hoppers than that little farm I just made, but we'll see how it goes. I'll show you when I made some progress on it. Okay. Well, I AFK'd it all night. And looks like all my her legs have grown up, obviously. And we got 16 scoots. And lots of turtles. I've already bred them, and there's plenty of turtle eggs on the ground there. So now, cycle of life continues, and they die. I don't need these guys anymore. Ooh, I didn't break any eggs today. I have a nice convenient place right here. I can put inventory in this hopper right here. Like that. Oak logs. Not those. Seagrass. Not belongs in here. Already. Whoa. That goes fast. Won't seem so threatening to them. Whoa, they go fast. Look at that. Looks like it's no waste of time. Cool. Alright, I'll come back to them later. Not gonna work this, so I'll just smile. things off in here. You know, I thought that wasn't going to make any noise. I'm kind of disappointed that I keep hearing the minecart rattling. If I'd known it was going to do that, I would have had just one going on a circle, on a cycle. I would have known it was going to be constantly making that sound like that. But oh well, here we are. Okay, I have a shulker box full of scaffolding in the smelter. I think I worked out all the kinks, and here we go with about 3 stacks of stone. Here goes. Boom. Almost. But this has something, I don't know. Oh, no. Oh, there it goes. There they go. What number is that one? 5 from the end. Oh, it's not on this side, that's the fuel side. So yeah, we're almost done anyway, so. I'd say close enough for Jess. It's working. It's all, yeah, look at that. Okay, it's not quite fully balanced. I don't know if this one has 4. Like some shouldn't be any loss in the shuffle. If you don't recognize it, this is El Mango's design. I did modify it slightly at the very end. There was a problem with his design that I found where the fuel, if the fuel fills up like these are doing, then the fuel hoppers can back up here and they don't get, and the fuel hoppers can get locked. So what I did, I'll show you back here, it's fairly simple fix. Easy to show you on the other side. If I can get over here. Here we are. This was his right here, ending at this block here. All I did was add this little line here, which takes the input so that when there's a new input, it just tickles the fuel line. So you have a repeater going down to a line to a repeater to this block here, so that every time there's 23 more on the input line, it just sends another one on the fuel line if there is any more to be sent and if the fuel is not full already. It's largely harmless because the fuel is often full anyway, and it means that you don't get the state where the fuel is backed up and locked. And button this mess up. I died to a creeper at one point, and my inventory is all messed up, so that's the reason for that, if you're curious. Okay, I think I've done a few redesigns of this thing, and I've come up with a final design that I think will work for me. I put a door on here so I can get in and out. I've got some babies in there that are ready to grow up. Oh, I think I just heard one grow up. No. Oh, the eggs, an egg is cracking. Okay. There are two stacks plus 39 scoots. And I have one hopper minecart just going around, and every now and then it goes over this hopper here. I could add another hopper two or two there so it goes faster, but it doesn't really matter that much. And then I have this hard rail at the end here is where I can control it if I'm tired of the noise of the rails, which I can hear too often. I can just turn the whole thing off and it'll go stop right there. It'll be nice and quiet. And I'll probably do that after they've all grown up, and then I can just come in here, grab some more seagrass and breed them, and then kill the adults, and then turn this on. But because there are babies ready to grow up, I will leave it running, and it'll do its thing. Yeah, there it goes. So, two stacks plus 39. Next time I see there's an adult there, I'll show you the count so you can see it's working. Okay, well, I just watched a few of them become adults, as you can see. There's a lot more babies there and a lot more eggs left to hatch. And let's take a look here. And now, yep, there are. Now there's 45 scoots instead of 39. So, yeah, it's working. I think I will just dispatch these guys and let the others be the ones I save for breeding. I'm not going to breed anymore until. I'm not going to breed the other ones until I get these guys out of the way. If you watch carefully, let's watch this one here. Watch that. What is that? Oh, this one here. Sometimes the items fall on the eggs and they don't get picked up by the... by the hopper minecart. So I go in there and pick things up by hand. Is that an egg or a scoot? That's a scoot. So if I drop it... Yep, there it goes. Yeah. Oh, wonderful. Get away from the door, please. I'm trying to leave. Away from the door, please. Thank you. There it goes. And there's 40s. I have one turtle shell and the ability to make a lot more. Oh, forgot one. And I'm getting some turtle heads too. I don't know why. So, I'd say that part's done. Let me also show you my smelter. It works quite well. I put in 2 stacks of raw steak and got out 2 raw beef and got out 2 stacks of steak rather quickly. I have a shulker box here, which is my fuel supply. I put a torch underneath it to tell me don't take anything out of here. I have to be very careful when I break this thing to keep the hopper powered. Otherwise, it will go into the hopper system and I'll have to run in there and dig around to try and find it. So, leave it there, facing this way so I can open it. And then I have... This little thing to power the hoppers underneath it in case I want to collect the XP. Here's my access area here. This is all dirt, which is not a good idea because Enderman can take it and leave zombies with an opening, which is not a good thing. There's another problem. Although I think I got around it by using stairs here. But when I had a solid block here, this redstone here was powering that hopper there, which ruined the whole ride. So I used stairs, which can't be powered. And that seems to work. And it works pretty well. Another thing I did was I spent some quality time with some of my villagers. And I've greatly improved my redstone chest. I have a nice supply of dispensers and droppers. Full stack of hoppers. I already have some note blocks and observers. Got some pistons, sticky pistons, and redstone lamps. Full stack of redstone blocks and dust. And a full stack of repeaters and comparators. And got some target blocks, and should probably get some more torches. And a stack of slime and honey blocks. Oh, you know what I should probably put here? Some of those fans. That's a good component. So, I'm starting to get this more organized. That doesn't belong in there. I don't know why I'm carrying that around. Actually, I do. This is my iron chest. I use it for when I go to the iron farm or when I want to make some money. I cleaned out my toy box. There was a lot of useless garbage in there. This is my random chest, block chest basically. And I have an emergency diamond pick in case I need to break the ender chest. Extra arrows for reasons I'm not entirely clear of. Well, yeah, if I don't have any arrows, my bow doesn't work. I have an extra silk touch axe. I don't know why I'm carrying that with me. Actually, that belongs in here. Let's take care of that right now. You belong there. Ivan Ho, I should probably rename that crazy Ivan. I don't need the shears on me all the time. Probably don't need the fortune pick on me all the time either. And let me show you what I've done in the storage area. This is still a work in progress. What I've been doing is the last chest that does not have stuff in it. Becomes my to-do list for sorting things. This is actually going somewhere else. This is going up on the top of this. So all this purple and prismarine is going on this. This is random esoteric building blocks. Oh, yeah, it's a mouthful, but I'll take it. So, purple. Basically, purple and prismarine. I don't have as good a supply of prismarine yet, but hopefully someday. I think I'll put the sponges with the prismarine. Well, they're all going up in here anyway, so. Prismarine crystals. And the lamps get us one. What else? Anything else up here? No, okay. Oh, sponges. Maybe endstone. Okay. Yeah, just random esoteric building blocks, basically. Quartz, I might put that here and may move that offline somewhere else. Popcorn fruit is going to go here. I've got a whole bunch of that right over here. Actually, that one all fit there, come to think of it. I might have to just dedicate one chest just to the prismarine. We'll see. This ain't gonna fit. And then hopefully I'll be able to dedicate a chest to purple And then hopefully we'll all dedicate a chest to Prismarine. I would like to have a guardian farm at some point. But I don't have one yet. I don't have much need or use for a lot of quartz stuff, so I don't have much there either. That's alright. I think Jack's going to go here. I have a place to put the furnace. I thought about putting it in the redstone. But, oh, so here's what I have. I have that. This is my redstone chest. Some basic stuff here. I don't have a whole thing of repeaters and everything. This is mob drops, cooked and raw. Not everything's cooked. This is slime and honey. This is my gunpowder chest, which is basically a copy. I just moved it over here from the other side. And this is my current to-do list, as it were. And whenever I get new stuff, if it doesn't get filtered somewhere else here, it gets filtered there. And let me pop that there, and I'll grab this one. I'm going to call these esoteric blocks. I may rename it Purper. And then use another one for the Prismarine. Come on. There. That's the tart blocks. Can't even read it there anyway. Okay. Shift down the hot bar and yeah, so slowly but surely I'm creeping along here. I've got one left. I don't know if I showed you this properly. I think I will do that. Can't use that. I'll use leads. Might have showed this to you, but listen carefully. Everything here is all filtered out. It was all blocked. There's no place for anything in here. Well, it's nighttime. I'll just sleep before I can show you everything. Yeah, it's noisy. On purpose. And there are the leads. So, this is the overflow chest. Let me sleep and then get up on the roof. So this, as you know, is my abnormally large, my unnaturally large jungle tree. It's a 3x3 jungle tree, which is extremely rare, by the way. Okay, it never happens. More's a pity. It looks cool, I think. I like it. And I've got this weird little bump out here. And down here at the bottom, I have this little hill here. And hidden inside this hill. Oh, I'm sorry, yeah, I need that. Is all that annoyingly loud redstone contraption that I keep hearing. There's a piston and this pops up and a hopper timer and stuff like that. So this yeah, so that's a dispenser. I mean dropper. And then when this yeah, so when it powers, this goes up and that ticks, 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 makes a racket, etc., etc., and pushes everything into a water column, a bubble baiter, of course. And that bubble baiter, let me clean up my mess here. That Bubblebaiter is right in the middle of the tree. The reason I wanted a 3x3 tree was because I wanted to be able to have water, a water stream in the middle of it. The water stream is right there in the middle of it. So it goes up there in the middle of it, over into this hopper down here. Now tell me you aren't surprised. So that hopper there, there's water above it. So it goes down to here. I could have used a quieter one, I know, but I wanted to know that something is coming into here. If there's, so that I know that things are being overflowed. And we're actually one chest away from that happening. So this is going to be my next to-do list, because these are all, as I said, filled with walker bamboo. The last thing to show you is a little terraforming I did. Okay, very little. On the roof of over here. I should do more of it, you know, add some leaves and some more vines to it. But this is basically the roof of my, that shouldn't be like that. That should be dirt. The roof of my smelter. And you see from the outside how big it is on the inside. Kind of wanted to hide it, make it look natural, but let's face it, I'm no Scar. So, need to figure out a way to make it look like it belongs here. But long, straight things like this just don't look natural. What can I say? Meanwhile, I have plenty of trees. I've turned off this. You can see they're all full and ready to harvest. I moved everything here down to my chest, my storage system. I showed you that already. And that's it, I think. That'll do it for this episode. It wasn't very flashy. The only big thing I did was the smelter. And it's just a bunch of tinkering around the base, you know? I think it was fun and nice and relaxing. I kind of want to get back to the Nether. Want to do an iron golem farm, not iron golem farm, blaze farm. I made another, I needed another, brewing stand for a villager, and, you know, to get more redstone. And realize that I'm running out of blaze rods. So I need to go back to the Nether and make that a little more automated. And maybe while I'm there, I can get my third wither skeleton skull and get a beacon. Ooh. Whoa. Yeah, that'd be nice. I know exactly where it's going too. I'll show you right now. This is something I'm planning to. Little retro thing. Beacon is going right here. If I can, I need to make sure the shirt fits here too. We'll see. Find a way to make it fit. Yeah. And then I'm planning a little surprise something down here. I think I should probably light that up. Anyway, so. Turtles in the background. Oop. I'm falling. Oh, and they're grown. Okay, well, thank you for watching. And I'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.